Today on Big Brother's Little Brother, we investigate the phenomenon of the housemate auras. I'm not entirely sure what this means. To be honest, I think it's a bit of mumbo jumbo. Just lighting. Oh, hello, loves. How are you? Excuse my nerves. I'm very, very excited because today is a Tuesday, ergo it's Nomination Tuesday, and that means that in about 40 seconds we're crossing live to the house to tell our housemates who is up for nominationes. Also on today's show, Nina Ashby is going to be showing us the housemates' true colours by reading their auras. Going to be finding out a bit more about that later on. Very exciting. And we're going to update you on our Save Sheriff Stew campaign, which is going very well. We took Stew's super fan down to Wimbledon yesterday. It's very exciting. And of course, Vanessa is going to be taking your calls. But now the moment has come. I think it's going to be quite exciting. Oh, look, there's Vanessa there getting out. Oh, look, that's not even a win machine either. Very impressive. OK, but the moment has come. Let's cross live to the house now for the nominations.
Big mouth. When you're like 9 year old, it's like big mouth, isn't it?
Big mouth.
I was just always like that.
This is Big Brother. There are 3 people nominated for eviction this week. They are, in alphabetical order, Marco and Michelle and Nadia.
Damn.
Okay, girls.
I need to get lots of attention.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, I want to go now. I want to go now.
No, don't do that yourself. Don't do that.
I really didn't think you'd be up, so I don't think anybody else will.
What it did for me, it just took a huge weight off my shoulders, and I thought, if I am going to go, I might as well have the time of my life for the last week.
What is wrong with me? The only time I...
Please. No, Michelle, come on.
I'm going.
No, you're not going anywhere, Michelle. You're not going anywhere. You're not thinking straight.
Michelle, don't go, because whatever Michelle, happens don't go in anywhere. Here, people
please,
outside will probably
we can do this together.
Your door, you anyway.
Do you know what I mean? We can do this together.
I don't want to be up against you still.
So anyway... How's your day, all right? Oh, well, she's going in to see Big Brother. She wants to go, but I think Nadia's trying to talk around it, as is Shell and Marco there. So, Marco, Michelle and Nadia all up for eviction on Friday. However, in true Big Brother style, an evil twist was added to the nominations process this week. We can reveal not all of the nominated housemates were chosen in the traditional way, and if Michelle finds out, she's not going to be happy. Tonight's nominations uncut on E4 at 7 p.m. and the main show at 10 p.m. for the full story. So, who goes? You decide, and these are the numbers to call. All right, it's Tuesday. We know who's up for eviction on Friday. With that in mind, today's call, BBLB, is are the Jungle Cats back in control? Are they winning the game? I'd imagine Jason and Victor are very happy that he's up for eviction this week. Here's how to get in touch. OK, the Big Brother house has been very colourful this week, to say the least, not least today. Here to discuss what the housemates' auras say about them is Nina Ashby. Hello, Nina.
Hello.
OK, first question. What is an aura and how do we read it, or how do you read it?
Right, well, the aura is the human energy field, and there are lots of different layers to this energy field. And
right.
This particular part of the aura stores information as colour, and that information is mental, emotional information.
OK. So what influences someone's aura? I mean, is it their emotions? Is it what's happening right now? Or do they always have the same colour?
Well, there's a dominant energy colour that... Whoops.
Hello.
That talks about their personality and tells about their life challenges.
And that's permanent.
That's permanent.
Yeah.
That's permanent. But the colours of these centres up the middle of the picture are their chakras, and they are centres of consciousness, and they change colour according to what's going on with that person in their life at that particular point in time.
So obviously there's several colours, that
well, the full spectrum.
Sure.
She's got all the colours of the spectrum in her aura in different shades.
So you're going to talk us through each of the potential evictees. But, for example, obviously, Nadia's dominant colour here is, you described
violet.
It as violet. Yes. In rehearsal, I called it navy blue, and that's wrong. So, violet, what does violet say about someone?
Violet people are very intense people. They like to have kind of close-up, intense relationships, and then they need a lot of space. But the thing about violet people, they're into power.
Yep.
And manipulation and transformation.
Really?
And they transform other people's lives as well as within themselves. But you never really know everything that's going on with a violet person.
Okay.
Secrets.
Just very briefly, what about all these little colours here? What are they telling us?
Okay, well, what's interesting about Nadia's aura is that she's got different colours on the right side to the left side of her picture.
Mm-hmm.
And that tells the right side is about how she relates to people in the house in the outside, up front world.
Yep.
And lots of diplomacy, which is this... kind of apricot color.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. And pretending to be, well, actually quite emotional, touchy-feely to certain people.
Just very briefly, what does the left side tell us?
The left side is more about herself.
Right.
And you've got grey and pink, which is vulnerability and fear and frustration.
Okay, brilliant. Okay.
Okay.
What have we got next here? Oh, it's Michelle.
Michelle.
I imagine this color isn't going to stay this color for long.
Well, her blue will stay the same because that's her nature, but her chakra colors have already from that.
So what's the blue telling us to start with?
Oh, the blue's telling us that she is very flirtatious, a quite social person, and she's an investment in seeming to be nice.
Mm-hmm.
And she's somebody who has a very strong aesthetic nature, but she doesn't like it when people, what she perceives is to be dishonest with her.
Yeah.
That's like the bottom line.
And how?
But she's very also... She's
What's
quite a jealous person.
Is she?
And she's really, she has a very strong intuitive nature, and she uses her, she like sends a lot of kind of nasty thoughts to people sometimes.
Really?
Yeah,
okay.
Really strong
Certainly
thoughts to
moment.
People. But she is kind of a control freak.
Okay, let's have a look at the next one. You can tell these, just, you don't have to meet someone to tell these, you can see through, obviously
there's
so much access on big
Yes.
someone that does what you do. So,
mm-hmm.
And that's all you need. Okay, and this last one here, Marco.
Well, Marco's really interesting because his dominant colour is turquoise, which is that kind of laughy, flirty, outrageous side. But he's got all these, like, violet colours in the solar plexus, and that really means that he's sitting back, he's watching, he's got a game plan.
Is that what his green tells us around
strategy.
His groin there and the old chest?
Well, that's the, I want to be the leader, I need to be the leader, I'm seen to be the leader. But turquoise people have trouble making commitments,
okay.
And green is a challenge for him because he is seen as a leader, but he has trouble taking responsibility.
Okay. So our challenge for you is to watch the housemates for the next 50 minutes and do as many alternative diagrams, as it were, for the three potential evictees.
Right.
So that's how they were before they knew they were nominated. We need three more, if you would.
You've got
your own crayons.
Yep.
We appreciate that.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. More from Nina later on. Okay, I'm sure you're well aware, last week we launched our Save Sheriff Stu campaign, which is ace. Simply want Big Brother to give Stuart his cowboy outfit back. Although they won't admit it, Big Brother's been feeling the pressure. They made a small, ridiculous, pathetic concession by allowing Stu to buy a cowboy hat with a weekly shopping allowance. Here's the hat in question. It's... It's an insult. Rightly, Stuart thought the hat was slightly too big. Big Brother offered him the chance to have a smaller hat. They're toying with him. Take a look at this.
Stuart, please find your replacement hat on the diary room chair.
Thank you very much, Big Brother.
Guys, I got my new cowboy hat. I got my new cowboy hat, yeah. I'm wearing it at the moment.
What's he done?
Give him the tiniest hat that will. Oh, do you know what I mean? It's ridiculous. Go get Sammy back now.
I don't laugh. There's nothing funny about this. Simply not good enough. Stu deserves a full cowboy hat recognition in his proper outfit, as do the ladies of Britain. Our Save Sheriff Stu campaign, supported by Stu's superfan Glenn, has been gathering pace, and yesterday even diehard Tim Henman fans took their minds off tennis to help save Sheriff Stu. Take a look.
Save Sheriff Stu. These people need these in their homes, in their cars, even in their saloons. It's time to go. The campaign starts now. Excuse me, sir. Save Sheriff Stu. Thank you very much, my man. Come on, save Sheriff Stu. Madam? Okay, maybe not. Got anything for a hungry nag here? Rex likes his fast food. Wishing my gal was by my side. Rex and I are in agreement. The word needs to be spread, and it needs to be spread now. Are you ready, people?
Yeah.
You all want to save Sheriff Stu?
Yeah.
Save Sheriff Stu! Save Sheriff Stu!
Save Sheriff Stu!
And there you have it, Dermot. Save Sheriff Stu. You know it makes sense. A fruitful day, I'm sure you'll agree, Rex. But sadly, our work here is done. I know, I know. It's time to go.
This is the hat that belongs on Stuart's head. We want you to show your support. Take your banners down the streets. Put the posters in your windows. Shout it from the rooftops. Save Sarah Stu. Be sure to send a picture with all the photographic evidence. You know how to get in touch. It's on the screens now. After the break, we're going to be talking to Vanessa about this week's nominations. We're going to have our Aura update with Nina over there. And, of course, Cool BBLB. We'll see you in three. Hey, welcome back to Big Brother's Little Brother, still joined by Nina. It's a very small seat we've got for you there, Nina.
Yes,
I do apologise.
Well, that's my baby chair.
How's it going?
Very interesting.
Really?
Very, very interesting, and a big change, obviously.
Oh, just, I'm going to ask you
volatile.
More about this later. Just tease me with a little bit of information.
Well, some people have closed up and some people have exploded.
Say that again in your best New York accent.
Some people have closed up really and some people have totally exploded.
Thanks. OK, we're now joined with someone who obviously knows exactly how it feels to be nominated. The horse's mouth, as it were. Ladies and gentlemen, Vanessa.
Hi there.
Mental.
No.
Oh, come on. That reaction was incredible.
Yeah, reaction was amazing, but, you know, I thought that, you know,
okay,
happen.
First of all, the results. Are you surprised by the results?
No, not really.
But I am, for the simple reason. I thought, I would literally stake my house on the fact that Jason was up for nomination this week.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's two groups, and, like, they keep on nominating, like, you know, one group, it's, you know, once a week, it's this group nominating that, and, you know, so it's the shifting
power. Shifts, doesn't it? It's really interesting.
Totally.
But I'll tell you why I thought, because Dan and Shell are getting slightly annoyed with Jason now because they just Dan keeps saying he's dull as dishwater. And,
yeah.
You know, and I think Shell's getting annoyed with him because every now and again he loses it. So that's why I just thought they'd be voting him out.
Yeah, I thought Dan, Jason may have had a bit of, you know, being nominated, but obviously, you know, Nadia and Marco are irritating the other housemates.
Who would you have nominated this week?
Nadia and Marco.
Those two?
Yeah, I said so to Davina on Friday.
Okay.
So I'm not surprised.
And your opinion hasn't changed from what you've seen this week. You would have still nominated them.
Yeah, probably.
Okay. Why was that? Because of the altercation you had with Nadia and because Marco...
No.
Is Marco quite full-on to live with?
Yeah, they are, you know, they're massive personalities and sometimes it's just a bit too hectic because it's constant noise. I mean, they're great people, but sometimes you just, you know, you just don't want the seal noises and the hyenas and everything.
Yes. How did you feel when your name was called out? Looking back, sort of.
I was actually expecting it.
Were you?
Yeah. When they said Dan, and I was like, oh my gosh, Dan's been, you know, so his name's come through. And then my name, I was just like, oh, there we go. But it was okay. I didn't mind too much.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Well, Michelle threatened to walk. She's probably in the diary.
Yeah, that's quite dramatic.
Do you think that's an empty threat? Do you think she's just saying that heat of the moment and she's a bit annoyed, or?
I think it's probably heat of the moment.
Okay. I mean, are you surprised at her reaction?
I am a bit, because when I, you know, was nominated, I think I took it quite well. You know, obviously you feel, you know, quite disappointed and everything, but then you've just got to laugh about it and say, oh, well, it's a game.
But this is the first week. I think there's been so much division in the house now that this is the first week there wasn't that kind of collective group hug, and it was like,
yeah,
hey, come on, everyone has to do it, and we'll help you through it. This week it was just hug yourselves. Jason sat there, Victor sat there, said absolutely nothing.
Well, because they've obviously nominated for them, and they're not going to do the whole big false thing, oh, I'm really sorry, because they're not really.
Mm-hmm. Okay, lastly, who do you think is going to go?
Michelle.
You reckon? By a big vote?
Oh, probably not as big as mine.
OK. Oh, I wasn't going to mention that. OK, Vanessa's going to be joining us for a cool BBOB, so it's going to be Marco, Michelle or Nadia up for eviction on Friday. Here's a reminder, at the moment they found out, it's dynamite.
This is Big Brother. There are three people nominated for eviction this week. They are Marco and Michelle. And Nadia.
What is wrong with me? The only time I haven't been up for eviction is the one week when nobody could nominate me. Do you know what I mean? What am I doing wrong?
Stop it, darling.
I mean, amazing scenes in the Big Brother house. And I think they're reflected here, aren't they?
Totally.
I wouldn't know anything about this, but you can talk.
But you can just see it, can't you? Because here, it looks much more self-contained. And here, all of a sudden, everything is going in.
Yeah, sure.
And all this grey is fear.
What's this blue? Where does this come from?
Well, that blue is all the emotional shock of it.
Right.
And you can see also this lilac colour, which is about feeling isolated, wanting to draw back and withdraw, and emotionally very, very stressed and tense and worried. Very, very worried.
What's
and vulnerable.
What's that colour there? That sort of,
that's
that
kind
the white?
Of a, that peach and white,
peach,
that's fear and vulnerability. And it's got this ochre colour, which is all stress, worry, 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 worry.
And these sort of little squiggles of yellow, what are they saying?
Well, the yellow is her trying to get a handle on it mentally. Trying to think of new strategies. How, you know, what's the implication of this, and you know, who did what and why.
And she took it well. So let's see what Michelle.
Yeah, well, doing. what she does is her control is she goes in.
Yeah.
Okay. So we go.
I can't wait to see the next one.
Yeah. Oh, that's wrong side.
Whoa! Hello there.
Right. Hell hath no fury than a woman scorned.
Really? Is that,
yes, and for a blue person, betrayal is the big problem.
Mm-hmm.
And she's felt betrayed by her housemates for having nominated her. And so this is rage, anger, venom. And that's what happens, is like this huge explosion of anger, energy, which the viewers saw.
Is that what this red's saying to
that's
us?
That's red, and it's also accompanied by the peach, which is that vulnerability. She's angry because she feels vulnerable.
Yeah.
And she's also grey up here mentally. That's all fear.
Sure.
What's going to happen?
Why is this sort of centred around sort of the torso area, specifically, and the chest?
Well, because the solar plexus, this one, is about how the gut feeling and how that erupts. And the heart centre is how you feel inside of yourself. So that's what she's feeling, and this is her head. So, you know, huge amount of mental energy and mental control, because blue people like herself are very controlled.
And there's nothing down there at the knackers, which suggests to me she's got no time for Stu at the moment.
Well, she's worried about Stu. She still wants to maintain her power base, but now she's worried, that's the pink, that maybe something's all right.
And lastly,
Well, he's got more of a boundary around him. Mm-hmm. He's consolidating. He's not being all light and fluffy.
Yeah.
And he's got this insecurity green around him. And again, we see the gray of fear, the pink of vulnerability in the heart.
Yeah.
He feels emotionally stirred up and insecure. And gray, what am I going to do? The strategy is all going down the drains. It's been displaced, and he's very worried. And now he's going to go in terms of, this is the relationship center.
Mm-hmm.
He's going on the diplomacy charm offensive.
Brilliant.
Okay?
Thank you very much, Leah.
My pleasure. I'd love to. Oh, thank
okay,
you.
Right. Today's Cool BBLB is quite simply, are the Jungle Cats back in charge? I would probably say yes now after that stunning nominations today. Let's go straight to the phones as soon as we can, still with Vanessa. Kevin from Scotland, hello.
Hello, Dermot.
How are you, Kevin?
I'm fine, yourself?
Brilliant, not much time, let's go for it.
I don't think the Jungle Cats are winning at the moment. Sargit of Wind have got to enlist the help of Ahmed and Dan.
Yeah. Do you think they need Ahmed and Dan to win?
Ahmed is like an independent of the house at the moment. And obviously the Harim's up for nominations. And I don't think the Jungle Cats are going to win at the moment until they get Ahmed and Dan on their side.
What do you think?
I think Dan's more likely to win. I mean, the Jungle Cats, I see, you know, they're stronger at the moment, and it's a pulling power towards the Jungle Cats, definitely.
Okay, cool. Thanks a lot, Kevin.
Bye, Dags.
Thanks a lot. Bye. I imagine, Jason and Victor, there'll be some talk tonight, won't there?
Oh,
where everyone's gone to sleep, and those two are going to be high-fiving like there's no
tomorrow. Absolutely. Yeah, I think so.
Jason's going to be ecstatic about this.
Yeah, I think he might be quite pleased. I mean, that's why, you know, there wasn't any hugging. Because I think they've come to the conclusion that maybe they want
Marco.
They
know like each other, yeah. Sure. Okay. Steph from Edgware. Hello, Steph.
Hi, Dermot. Hi, Vanessa.
Hi there.
Hi, I think the Jungle Cats will only know the result of whether their cerebral plotting has beaten the in-your-face antics of those hyenas when the public vote, because that's the test. And if the public vote the way I suspect they might, I think you'll find that we're going to like the in-your-face antics better than the plotting. So I'd be very surprised if Marco goes on Friday, and I'd be very surprised if Nadia goes.
Yeah.
I think those two will stay just to wind up those Jungle Cats for another week.
And if they stay, they'll probably be even stronger, right? Because they'll think...
Oh, definitely. Yeah. But the balance of power in the house is definitely held by Dan and Stuart and Shell, actually, even though, because they're not Jungle Cats or hyenas.
Yeah.
They're kind of in the middle. And wherever they drift, that's the balance of power. So they hold the key.
Absolutely.
You are so right. Cheryl from Southampton, very quickly, what do you reckon?
Hi, Dams. I agree with that. I don't think it matters who's going to win between the Jungle Cats and the Harim, because the people floating in the middle ultimately got the most power and they're going to come out on top. And I think Cheryl should win because her and Dan,
absolutely.
Her or
That's
Dan
where the smart
win.
One is going. Thank you very much, Cheryl. Thank you very much, Vanessa. To all our callers, thanks to Nina as well. Don't forget, Big Brother tonight, 10 o'clock. And, of course, nominations uncut, 7 p.m. on E4. We'll see you tomorrow at 6. Take care.